it should not come as a total surprise that some bandits breached security at the NDA, because the NDA does not even have the kind of fortification associated with military bases in the Northeast. So I am not entirely surprised. The only thing is, one would have expected that because armed banditry had been prevalent around the NDA area. Remember the students of the Federal School of Forestry Mechanization were kidnapped, over 100 of them, and their school was located adjacent to the NDA. So if the bandits could pull that off and they spirited those students into the forest, despite it being close to a military formation like the NDA, not far away from the Air Force base, not far away from the one mechanized division, then it shouldn't surprise anyone that they've done this. The disappointment, however, is that we ought, in the light of those attacks that I reported earlier, to the point that the bandits will not be able to get into the premises. That is the disappointment, that we left the place not secure enough to the point that the bandits could have access to the officers' quarters, killed officers, and then kidnapped one of them, for which they are already asking for ransom, and have spoken to members of his family. So I believe that when attacks are frequent in a particular area, the right measures ought to be taken to keep that area safe, not just for the sake of the soldiers, but for the sake of the people who inhabit that area. That we have not done that in the case of NDA is the reason I am immensely disappointed, not because bandits found a way to get into the NDA and facilities. Bandits have been overrunning military bases. Bandits have been killing soldiers. You know, so it's not really, that is not really the aspect of it that shocks me. It's the fact that we did not do anything to keep that area impregnable that is of immense disappointment to me.